Ladies and gentlemen, this next contest will be for 2-minute rounds and will be for the vacant lightweight title. And your fighter, fighting out of the blue corner, from Independent Gym with a record of 4 wins, 2 losses, and 1 draw, please welcome Lesley.
Hey guys, we've got 4 2-minute rounds here, and it's a lightweight title bout. This belt is vacant. In the blue corner, we've got Lesley Monks, and in the red corner, we've got Naomi Franklin. And here we go, Dan. Four 2-minute rounds, and if anything of the other fighter to go by, this is going to be a fast-paced, all-action bout.
Yeah, we've seen some absolutely brilliant fights tonight. They've all been really well matched, and I think this one's not going to be any different. It's for a title. It's a rematch, so there'll be redemption being sought. Both girls will be quite familiar with each other, so I'm expecting a quick start from both of them.
Yeah, I believe Franklin came off best the first time round, but you know what? Rematches, you never know, do you? Especially in a four-rounder. You know, you've got to just get your tactics right. You've got to go to a good start, haven't you?
Yeah, and this is a different weight. This is the higher weight, so let's see how it pans out. Naomi trying to get that backhand off straight away. The taller fighter. Needs to keep it nice and long.
Yeah, and you can see they both know what they're doing. They've got good guards. I mean, it looks like it's going to be well matched. You never know, redemption could be there for Monks. You see that Naomi, she works well off a jab.
Yeah, she's a taller fighter. You want to see her use that jab and keep it nice and long. And what I'm impressed with at the minute with the girls is they're both quite composed. Obviously, that's going to change now as the fight goes on, but they're composed, having a look at each other. You can really tell it's a title fight. Just think that Lesley here now, just think that she's maybe struggling with the range a little bit. She needs to get closer, let her shots go. Because like you said, it's a three-round fight. She needs to get back down to business quite quickly.
Right, so guys, the action is coming in thick and fast here. If you're just joining us, we've got 4 2-minute rounds. 12-ounce gloves as well, Dan. So, you know, they're going to feel the shots, aren't they?
Yeah, they're going to feel the shots, yeah. Nice right hand.
Naomi looks like a coiled spring, like she's ready to launch into action. At the minute, it's quite cagey, isn't it? It's probably the most cagey fight we've seen so far, but it's probably because they've been in the ring with each other before.
I think they've been in the ring, they know each other. And the first round, they're just having a good look at each other as well, and they'll get back to the corners. The corner men will give the advice out. I think we might see a different second round. I think both girls might bring it a bit more in the second round.
Okay, there we go. Round one in the bag. Of course, these are 2-minute rounds. I think there won't be too much that needs to be addressed just yet. Maybe they need to up the tempo a little bit. But like you say, it's cagey because they face off with each other. And they probably had a good bout, so they're just keeping it cool. Getting it all set up nicely for that rubber match. So Franklin, the current super lightweight champion of the PBL, and she wants to get that double champion status. And you can see why, she's a good compact fighter.
Yeah, she is, she's a good combat fighter. Both girls are showing good fundamentals in there. Impressed with what I saw in the first round.
So coming into this one, Monks was adamant that she was the true winner in the first contest. So it was a bit controversial by the sounds of it. So probably why they're boxing cagey, because it's got a lot on the line. They both felt they won the first fight. And here we go, the action has hotted up already.
I think Naomi's corner was on to her, make a fast start. She looked like she'd come out a little bit quicker. But Lesley, she doesn't look the easiest to hit. She's got good footwork, she moves about, she's quite tall, quite rangy.
Yeah, that's the problem when you're a shorter fighter. You've got to get past the jab, and it's the fundamental thing there. But she did it well there, she just closed the range, put good foot speed.
Yeah, and then when she gets inside, she needs to work, she needs to let those hands go.
They're thinking about it. They're both trying to draw a lead on a counter shot, aren't they? They're both throwing feints. They're both trying to get a counter shot. And that's a good shot from Lesley, that. She very clever there, what she did. She didn't react to the feints.
Yeah. Naomi just needs to get in close. Needs to get in close and let her hands go. At the minute, she's spending a bit too much time at range. And that's just suiting Lesley a bit too much. But it's difficult because she has got long arms. Just needs to move that head, maybe double jab.
Oh, that's she a got good out of the way there. Yeah, she got out of the way nicely as well. I think in this one so far, Leslie's just got the strategical advantage. She's just holding the centre of the ring, isn't she? Yeah. Picking her moments nicely.
Yeah, good performance from Lesley, to be honest. She's just done exactly what she needs to do. Just keep it nice and long. Good jab.
Oh, good little short left hook. I think they both landed at the same time there.
Yeah. Good action, Aki. I'm impressed with the technical attributes of both of them. They're quite good. They've got the fundamentals well, but I just feel now it's a big final round. I just feel like Naomi needs to go out and try and get the stoppage.
Well, they've got 4 rounds to work in, actually. So this halfway stage, And yeah, I mean, that's the thing. You've got, if you don't get off to a good start, Dan, you're chasing, aren't you?
Yeah, you are. That's, you don't want to be at that stage. You don't want to be chasing the fight.
I've been impressed with Leslie's long range movement. She boxed well off the back foot.
I think Leslie's got the tactics right. Just keep it nice and simple. Keep it nice and simple. Nice and long. And if Naomi does get close, just tie her up a little bit.
Now, tactically, Naomi's got to get past the range, get past the jab. She did it quite well at one point. She used the footwork. The footwork was nice, nice and fast, fast feet. She needs to throw fate, move to the angle slightly, get in, but it's easier said than done. She's trying it there, though, you can see.
Yeah, she's moving the head. She's starting the round well, but... And she's trying to get in, and she's trying to get into range, but it's just difficult for her.
But you know what? Leslie's not reacting, and that is the best way to deal with a fighter in front of you, is moving a lot and fainting a lot. Yeah, don't react to the feints.
And Leslie's just taking that little half step back. She's very, very smart in what she does.
That's a good one. That's better from Naomi.
Much better. You can't fault Naomi's effort. She's doing everything right. She's fainting. She's moving ahead. But it's difficult. She just can't get past that range.
And is Trevor going to tell them to fight more? Or is he going to? What's he going to tell them to do? We don't know because there's no mic on him. But I wish there was so we could just hear what he's saying to him. Thing is, though, sometimes when a ref tells you, I don't know if he said that, I'm just saying, but you know, sometimes when a ref says that, you know, especially in the amateurs, it can affect the tempo and the rhythm and the tactics.
Yeah, of course it can. I think if he was saying that, I think it's a little bit harsh because it is a good fight. It's quite technical.
But we'll try and find out afterwards.
Yeah, there's certainly a lot of action in this fight. It's quite an interesting matchup.
It looks to me like Leslie's come out and saying, you know what, I'm going home with the win today because of what happened last time. Yeah, and she's boxing to a plan, isn't she?
Very, very disciplined performance. But Naomi, you can see she's dangerous in there. She's landing shots.
Yeah, and you might see, you know, coming towards the end of this round and certainly into the last round, she'll take a lot more risks. As we come into the end of the third round. Closer round.
And she's good, Leslie. She puts that jab out. Even though it's not landing, she's still putting it out.
And there's clearly a bit of respect there. She gives us a little wink there, so she must be feeling confident. Yeah, there's respect there. Touch gloves at the end.
For me, Leslie's took the three rounds. She's looking good in there. She's looking quite accomplished. Her technique's good. And I think she's using a reach advantage really, really well.
Watch it be 3-0 the other way now, Dan, with your scoring. Just watch. I tell you something, it's rocking in here. Every time one of these tunes comes on, I just want to get up and start dancing.
I can feel your leg under the table.
That's not my leg, mate.
What are you playing footsie with me to start off with? No, to be honest, it's been a very, very impressive night of boxing. Atmosphere's absolutely red hot in here. Music's been banging. And the fans have got what it came to see. You can see they're all happy, they're all excited. Plenty of support for the fighters as well.
Here we go into the fourth and final round. Who have you got winning? For us, we have got Leslie winning the fight. Leslie Monk. So let's see how Naomi will respond. And I tell you something, they're both going for it in this round, aren't they? They've both been told, probably rightly by the corner, go out and have a strong finish, which is what you want to be telling your fighters.
Been a very, very disciplined performance by Leslie.
Yeah, and I love the way she's held the centre ring.
Yeah, and she's not trying to be too greedy with it. She's just doing enough to win.
Yeah.
Scoring the points, moving out of range.
You know, I'm actually quite impressed with her, to be honest.
I am, because Naomi's a live opponent. She's moving ahead. She's fainting well. But she just can't get past that reach advantage.
Well, if it does go 1-1, they've got to have the trilogy, haven't they? Tony just asking him maybe to clear it up a bit.
I think you can tell as well that the girls have shared the ring with each other because they know what they're going to do. They've obviously studied each other. They know each other. And they've been cancelling each other out a little bit in there.
Yeah, they've probably been preparing for each other since the last fight. And you can see there in close quarters as well, they both want it, don't they? You cannot fault either of them, their intent and purpose in there.
Yeah, Lesley just switching stance there a little bit, going into that southpaw stance.
Yep, some good action here. The trading shots. Did she think she hurt her then? Because she really stepped on it there, Lesley.
Yeah, I think she sensed a bit of danger there. She's finishing very, very strong.
And this has been the best of the four rounds, hasn't it, in terms of action?
Yeah, I think you're right in what you say. I think the corner has told them to go out and win that last round. I think it's a great fight, good respect between them both. And Naomi, I think if she's fighting someone else, she might have got a win tonight.
Yeah, she thinks she's won though, you see. And this is the thing, you never know how the judges are scoring it. But
look, if I'm scoring that fight, I think Lesley, better boxing ability. She kept it nice and long. She was landing the quality shots. But Naomi certainly made a fight of it. It was entertaining, especially that last round.
Yeah. Well, let's see. Let's see how it goes.
But like you say, it sets up the trilogy fight, doesn't it?
Yeah, well, let's get the result first, mate. We might be singing before it's happened. You never know in boxing. For us, I mean, let's be honest, we know our boxing. So we know who's won in our minds. But we'll see. The title's in the ring with JJ Vance. Good fight from both ladies. They're both good fighters. I think it's going to be close, Dan, you know.
Split decision?
Well, could be. Let's see. Rightly so. Some respect for both boxers. They've worked really well, both of them. It's been scored a draw.
Oh, wow.
Well, there you go.
Well, that surprised me. And like you said about the trilogy fight, it sets it up nicely, I suppose.
Oh, what do you know, mate? You're only an ABA champion. Right, I'm going to go and see if I can interview him. Right, we've got both fighters. Not one, but two. Right, I'll start with you, Naomi. How do you, what do you reckon about the scoring?
Frustrating. Yeah.
Why are you frustrated?
Yeah. But I got a lot more body shots in, some good head shots, you know, a few more towards the later rounds. Yeah, went into it, take the first rounds a bit slower, and then, you know, take the up it in the last three rounds. Felt like I did, but it ended up a draw. But credit to her, she did a good job too.
Well, I've got to say credit to both of you before we go to Lesley. Now, Lesley, what do you make of it? So Naomi thinks she just nicked it.
Yeah, I think I just nicked it, to be fair, but I think it's frustrating for us both because we were just, I don't know, we were like holding off a bit. I think maybe it's because we had a bit more respect for each other because we fought before, so we sort of holding off because we know what each other have got, you know. But yeah, it was good. Obviously, the result's not the best, but...
No, we were saying that in commentary because we could tell you'd boxed before, and obviously we know you boxed before, but you could tell because you kind of were anticipating each other's moves a little bit, you know. You kind of like, it was as if you knew each other really well and you were sparring partners. You know what I'm going to say now, girls? We're going to have a third fight, aren't we?
Yeah, definitely.
Triology, yeah.
You're like frenemies. You're like friends but enemies, aren't you?
Yeah.
Right, so you're up for the third fight?
Yeah, I am, definitely.
You're up for the third fight?
100%, yeah.
So we need to see it really on PBL 11, don't we?
Yeah, definitely.
What are you going to do differently next time, Naomi?
Probably go for a bit more in the earlier rounds. Fitness was absolutely fine, so I wouldn't worry about it next time, yeah.
Lesley, what are you going to do next time?
Lift that belt.
All right, well, listen, you've got to give it up to both ladies, because both ladies put it all on the line there. It was a cagey technical fight, and then the last round, you've seen how much they both wanted it. And I would definitely watch the third fight. So, well done. Both go and celebrate, enjoy, and see you on PBL 11, hopefully. There you go, guys. We're going to be coming to you with our next fight shortly, so go and get a brew, and we'll see you soon.